502 by an English summer winter. This film captures a day in the life of sea anglers aboard a professionally chartered boat. It's a beautiful warm morning with ideal weather conditions. A perfect day, in fact, for sea angling. Let's hope those fish feel the same. Submerged continental shells extend from landmasses, some protruding as much as 200 miles beneath the oceans. These are the natural feeding grounds for many of the fish that we depend on for food. And also the hunting grounds for sporting sea anglers, not interested in nourishment of the stocking line, they pursue fish for the sheer thrill of maximum intelligence against basic instinct. Of landing a prime specimen, even snatching the national record. This item is after one of the most exciting fish in British waters. Can you hear the layout? The days of the old style fishing boat on the lake, chugging along the lake of the fish, half a million years ago. Travelling time is wasted time to the fishermen, and they want to get up and over the side as quickly as possible. Aggressive skippers like Steve Stone are investing money in these high-powered craft to feed their customers into deep water for a full day's fishing. Sarah Louise, a 33-foot Cygnus fiberglass charter boat, powered by a stand-up turbocharged diesel diesel. Modern craft is equipped with a trusted footwell that has been applied to 20 knots. She carries a comprehensive range of electronic equipment, dog safety, and fish fighting. Modern technology, working hand in hand with the skipper's natural intuition of finding the right fish in the right place at the right time. To take along to the party. Sea anglers, in common with other sportsmen, tend to bring their friendship, their cherished, indeed, and beloved equipment with them. Although, of course, their experience carries its own rights and comfort. What Derek's doing, in fact, is putting together trace lines and inhibited equivalent to take the twists and turns of struggling fish, and all important, share in. And by the way, this particular class of imaging is explained in detail towards the end of the film. Tope are members of the two shark family. The young are born alive during the summer months, and the average of 20 to 40 embryos are normally killed in the female, although there have been embryos of up to 50 in some pelagic mothers. The number of sharks frequently drink water. The legal, pressure, blue sharks are very occasionally the ferocious nature, although that's happier in the northern waters of the North Atlantic that wash the southern shores of Portugal. By British standards, Tope are large and powerful. The type of view from this part of the coast is lightweight. Needless to say, considerable skill is required to play a land of specimens that could, well, if you're lucky, weigh over 70 pounds. The UK boat record to date is 74 pounds, 11 ounces, although back in 1847, believe it or not, a monster of 9 feet was caught only a few miles along the coast from here. Freshwater fish are trapped in their natural environment. The sea anglers, however, understand the nature of the area he's fishing. This is the seasonal habit. He needs to know the correct bait, the right tackle, especially when fishing for one specific variety. In other words, you need to do your homework, and then perhaps you're in with fighting chance. We've arrived at this selected mark, and Steve's ready to explain his baiting up technique.
Help. What we use for you. Start with a nice coat of salt, that's what all that come on. Start on that. Working the wheel. Keep down at that come on. Any caution. A bit greasy, but enough both ways. Can't be avoided. Can't put in your face is bigger than this. We're standing for that. And this is why we do it. We used to work pretty well. It's a lot easier for us. I hit the hook. corn type bite. When I hear it, I ask what we're doing with it. Can't be much better than that.
Fishing for Tope is, of course, not a new sport. The difference nowadays, especially on this part of the coast, is that lightweight temperate suits, where they have line in comparison to how the fish will almost reach the board in the original manner. The general lengths say that all kinds of editing are unpredictable. There are some procedures they go to location, baiting, of course, but with the best wind in the world, if those fish don't want to bite, then they just won't bite. But of course, that's the great fascination of fishing. If the captains come to order, half the fun would go. A point worth noting, unlike the shark fishing of Japan, the latter is not ceremonious with our spot out in sunshine, although a few cold tons of lager have already been sunk and lost them to the seagull. In anticipation, and deep down, the hope. She's new to tope fishing, so who knows what her innermost thoughts are at this moment. For that right end of thoughts, this is the sum of the tension. Now, you don't need a vivid imagination to shut your eyes and dream of warmer climates. The sea is blue and real smooth. There's a tropical feel ready at the start of this hot and hazy day. Legged fish took the bait off the ridge and ran. The combined mental effort, winning those takes the sample of people millions.
I'm going to
The total domain is the number of the whole one point.
Pardon?
Not another nice shot of this lightweight line being used, remember, is only 15 pounds breaking strain. Come on, Dad. Are you going to be the first? He's picked his one up. Jake's obviously lost his one. As the lift around, long enough to filter the sun's intense rays, it's really warming up. Steve's practice eye confirms our solitude. Well, at least they're beginning to bite. It's just a matter of time now. There's certainly been no instant activity. The lights have sat and talked, swapped memories and smoked the empty cigarette, and waited. Notice how the lead is dropped outside the boat before crossing. This is it. Those rods must be brought in, as lines can quickly become entangled and the tope freshly dates before the tomato in its mouth.
He's a pimpy. I'm going to go to the next one. Well done, man. Well done, man.
The ladies think that the Tope never goes before when using a jet. However, due to tailor inadequate, put around the tail, you are meant to bring your terrestrial fish on board.
Down the bottom, you've got a cake, just where it is.
Well, that was it. The first of the day. A lovely finish. Not blessed, but a nice specimen to start off the day's activities. I didn't notice how clear the water was. We could almost be in the Caribbean. A typical day on a charter boat, especially when fishing for tope. Now they are the quietly happy one. It's always nice to bring the customer on board.
Hey guys, look, should we take?
Yeah.